can take you on company space bucks, Robin. You sure you want this? The research is in everything.
It is to me. And Sam. I need to know what happened.
The meteor storm.
I can use it for cover from Altera's eyes.
Gonna miss you, Robin.
I'll find my way back.
Approaching 45-46 feet. Surface temperatures. Drop pod deployed.
No!
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Vlad Hatter here, and we are having a sound issue. Like crazy. And it's a little better? Yeah, it's not so bad now. Anyway, we are at in Subnautica. Now, I played this quite a long time ago. I want to do a full series on it, but at the same time, like, my computer couldn't handle it, so here we are.
New blueprint synthesized.
All kinds of goodies. Alright, I'm gonna get out of here so I can hear myself think.
Holy smokes! That did not go as planned. I should find a way into the water and get to the drop pod.
Sure. So we are back on the wonderful world that is 4546B, where everything wants to kill you. Either wants to eat you or kill you or both. Well, just about everything. Absolutely just game. I love it. It's amazing. It's a great game. There's the survival aspect to it, base building, and then there's the underlying storyline arc of everything that you have going on. It's just awesome. I love this game. So, I wanted to hop back into it and bring you guys along for the ride, you know. And, yeah. I mean, I've already played it through once.
Oxygen.
My last bit of playthrough, like, so my original playthrough was before the actual 1.0 release. The last playthrough I was doing that I was doing this recording for was after 1.0, and
found the drop pod.
And then I started having issues with my computer, and it just wasn't good quality, and now I'm at a point where everything can be good quality, and yeah, so I'm starting over again. I don't need any of these players on me. Always forget this.
Well, Sam, I guess I might as well gather some tools and resources before starting my search. Hope that radio tower is as easy to spot as Lil said.
So, yeah. Basic things. We need to get some stuff. We need to start getting... You know, there's different components for various things we want to build. Need an O2 tank and some fins so we can move faster. I need to get a scanner, a survival knife. Flashlights help out a lot. And then I don't need to lock for right now. But yeah. So, from creep vine, which I need the knife for. I need to get clusters to get the... look on to make the knife. So the search begins. Maybe we got some stuff pretty close by here. There's creep vines, but I don't think any sea clusters spawn this close. It's that one. They're really thick, boys. These are the sea clusters.
New blueprint synthesized.
We're also gonna have to get some titanium.
Oxygen.
Yeah, I know. I'm trying to. I gotta get. No food tank. No oxygen. I'd rather stay underwater for longer, you know? We'll just kinda go through. Get some basic resources.
Should be able to use this.
Yeah, some titanium. I need more than one, though. There is two. I'm already lost. Not actually. I know where I'm going. Kinda, sorta. Don't judge me.
Oxygen.
There's so little oxygen there you first starting out. Constantly having to go back up. Need scanners, I got a sea glide going too. It's marked. And I've got these since we're here anyway. Another cool thing is a sun to surface, and you don't actually have to go all the way to the surface as long as you can make it into your door.
Oxygen.
Yeah. You would think whole bunch of water would come flooding in here, but you know, just magic, game magic, you know. I'll just stick with one for now. I need to be able to get the mesh stuff so that I can make a standard O2 tank. Don't you even think about it. Sea monkey. And those ones will steal your stuff.
New blueprint synthesized.
Thank you.
Oxygen.
I'm starting off is pretty slow. So we need to survive. Food, water, gotta get other, you know, survival situation taken care of.
Adding additional blueprints to your data bank.
Thank you.
The standard oxygen tank can be upgraded for deluxe and VIP breathing.
Floating air pump with some pipes so you can pipe air down, but I don't really use that. Use me a bigger O2 tank, that's all you need. Sure, I don't really need anything else at the moment. We will need a repair tool in time. What do I need for battery and titanium? Battery, I need the glowy thingies. Hi. I can't remember the name of it. We'll see it in just a second, though. So some these little caves. Yeah.
Ribbon plants contain electrolytic materials that can be used in energy storage.
Couldn't have said it better myself. batteries come in handy, very much handy. I think it auto-equipped my O2 tank. Right, so we need copper. Oh, God, he had copper. I'm gonna keep doing that just so y'all know. That's gonna be an almost never-ending thing. We open it up menu instead of exiting something like I'm trying to. So can you just barely offer
all right, I have a scanner.
Thank you. Now we must find the sea glide fragments. We already spotted that one. There it is. Also need glass. Need to be able to make a flashlight. Blah blah blah. We scan all we can. You know, get information about the flora and the fauna. You know, kind of get to know these waters. So good, dude. He's not looking so good, don't you think? I don't have to be consistent on there. Gotta finish the scan. Oop, there's another part. Got plenty of oxygen. One more to go, and then I can make it. There it is. Get back and make us a sea glide so we're not sitting there going slow everywhere. I have enough oxygen. That's fine.
Oxygen.
Yeah. Equipment, no, deployables, battery, lube, copper wire, titanium. Those, that one, copper wire and a battery, titanium, that's everything. Battery. Lubricants, foibles, give me a sea glide.
The sea glide is a personal transportation device used for high-speed free diving. Contains a built-in light and map.
See that? I pushed the right button that time. And I need a glass. And it's pretty light too. Hope so.
Hi guys.
But as you can see, there's a lot of bioluminescence to the world.
Calorie intake recommended.
No, you're not. I know, it's so pretty, isn't it? Curious little things. So, there is a lot that ends up happening in this game. But it's, like I said, slow going to actually get into the storyline of things. go through, get rid of all these, all my blueprints. And that's all good. Ghost logs. Yep, I know. Got the bang. I really want to go through all these right now. Search indigenous life forms, fauna, herbivores, sea monkeys, medium-sized and intelligent herbivore, which shows great interest in other life forms and their possessions. More research is needed to understand those life form and its behavior. Two finger-like appendages on each forearm are tipped with suction pads for basic object manipulation. Its large tortoise crest made of rigid bone is probably used as a ram, although it's not been observed. They roam the oceans almost playfully, largely fearless of predators, seem to form small nests where they hoard objects of interest for unknown purposes. And they're adorable. See, I'm doing it. I keep pressing the dang button. So, what to do?
Vital signs stabilizing.
Get a stockpile of some water and stuff. Pop that off. So what we need for water, filtered water is bladderfish, and then we can also cook, maybe if I grab one of my peepers here, come here.
New creature discovered. New creature discovered.
Boomerang and a hoopfish, just to get those out of the way. I don't know, can you guys tell
new creature discovered.
What really got me hooked is actually the first one. This is the sequel, first one. It's honestly, the first one, like, it was really good. But there's YouTubers, and you know, there's a lot of people that are actually covering the first one. Not a lot of people covering the second one. So, I figured I'd cover the second one. Just because if I were to cover the first one, I'd be playing modded. Come on. Modded Subnautica. Yeah, quite
oxygen.
A bit. I'll go to the surface for that one. Preserve from some food. Hey, I can stuff. I just make all the water I can. Yeah, I made sure to grab a lot. Be going out for water a whole lot. Honestly, I'm probably going to build my base about in the same area that I usually do. It's just a really good spot for everything we need. And I really didn't need to cook all those because they'll spoil over time. You can kind of see there. Don't do that. And drop off a bunch of those. Carry a couple with me, I guess. And now, what to do, right? Let's see, where are we? Middle of nowhere. Okay, good to know. I don't have a compass as of right now. So, just kind of going off of remembering things. Like, I know the layout, I gotta get my bearings. Is this the ice shelf? This gotta be the ice shelf. Okay. No. Yeah. Yeah, this has got to be the ice shelf. I to get salt. So I can cure food instead of having to cook it.
Oxygen.
And there's no O2 right here.
Dangerous weather approaching. Seek shelter.
Yeah. That's the beacon. No. No. I don't care. I don't care. You don't need it. It's for me, not you. Apparently I already have... be a hole there, isn't it? Okay, lost interest. What we got? Flare that I don't need. Bugs. We alright. I don't understand how I had that already.
Warning. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Yeah. I believe those things can, not that thing. The icicle thing can hurt you. Pretty decently.
Oxygen.
I'm working on it. You want to keep on going this way a little bit, even though it gets really dangerous the farther you go out over here. See if I can find my dude. Oh wait, there's something. That looks like a mobile vehicle bay fragment. And grab ball, or grab tap, whatever. I need to scan the creep vines too. Gonna go leave a big fragment.
Warning. Yeah, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
That helps. That is exactly what I have in my hand. I need that. One more mobile vehicle bay fragment. And it's a creature egg. We'll get into those later on.
Oxygen.
Uh-oh. Oh, I'm gonna make it. That's fine. Definitely need to start working toward high-capacity O2 tanks. Did I just go in circles? What? Still heading this way. I was just heading in circles. That's fun. This way I'm trying to head. Stay right along this ice shelf. Right out here is where it starts getting icy. Pretty dangerous.
oxygen.
No. Then the ice shelf side. Something specific I'm looking for. Must be too far out on this side. This, I believe, just kind of goes into the void. Essentially, like, not actually void, but pretty much void. Not see. I don't know. But I gotta be super careful. This coloration is weird. It definitely shouldn't be this blue. We are seeing a different color than my interesting. And kinda. I'm seeing everything with a very much blue tint. Yeah, this is definitely void side. I'm really scared to go that way. Kind of going sideways. Yeah, so there's thermal vents.
Warning. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
He spoofed me. Agreed. Yeah, he spoofed me. But that's not the guy I'm afraid of. By no means. But yeah, he can hurt you. He can do some damage. Yeah, unpleasantness. He is not the one I'm scared of, though. Sharks down this way. There's some stuff up here. Usually one or two brew shots hanging around. The mineral detector? Yeah. Which doesn't really help out, but you know, I'll pick it up. Just heck it, why not?
New blueprint synthesized.
Nutrient block. Yay. He's like, what could have possibly caused all this damage to this cage and stuff? Done that. I'll tell you what. There's a big that's hanging around here somewhere. Infected water. Ah. Okay. There should be a data box here as well. Okay, let's just scan everything. We're already kind of coming close to time.
Warning. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Wait, I don't need to rush up. I can rush right. And then pick up this. And that. That is sea truck dragon. Boy. No.
Warning. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
That's cool.
Warning. Passing 100 meters. Oxygen efficiency decreased.
Yeah, means it goes a lot faster. It's past 100 meters. Shark somewhere?
sounds like a distress call.
Transmission of unknown origin. Source of transmission depth calculated at approximately 200 meters. Oxygen.
I wonder. I know. I'm not gonna spoil it for you guys. If you watched my first series, it already spoiled you. We've been through all that. So yeah. End goal. Gonna get the mobile vehicle bay, get a sea truck. Gotta go down the coast, find out what kind of distress call is happening there. Yeah. So, computer chip is the hard part there. Yellow coral sample, gold, and copper wire. So I think I need some more copper, we need gold. I will take you along for just a little bit. Kind of. I don't really know what to talk about for this last little bit. Like. No gold there. Series, I don't know exactly how many hours it really takes to complete the game, you know? I'm happy with the deepness on these. But we'll just see. Kind of see how things progress. I know it gets pretty difficult to actually get the things toward the end game, but it's very doable. It's
just oxygen.
It takes a lot of getting things together, go get more stuff, and that's just how a lot of games roll. But if you made it this far, I want to thank you guys for hanging out with me. We got new theories going on here. This, and then we got another one going on. And then also we got Plasma going. I think Culprit here and there. I'm completely and utterly lost, aren't I? Looking for these freaking the bridge of the arches, these things, the deep section of those, but apparently I just lost. If you are enjoying it, please give us a like down below. Really helps out the channel a lot. Every little bit counts. And if you're new around here, consider subscribing. We're gonna have regular content going out on a regular basis. I'm really trying to get to that point. I will catch you guys in the next one.